Imagine a life where fame and fortune paint a picture of endless luxury, where sleek cars, a grand mansion, and a hefty net worth are just the beginning. This was the world of Takeoff, the Migos star whose success seemed boundless. But beneath the surface of his glamorous existence were untold stories of love and loss. In today's video, we're diving into the extravagant lifestyle that Takeoff built, from the high-profile relationships that made headlines to the stunning properties and cars that defined his success. Yet, as we celebrate his achievements, we must also confront the heartbreaking reality of his untimely death and the unsettling truths that still linger. Stay with us as we explore the dazzling yet tragic legacy of Takeoff's life. Takeoff, the acclaimed American rapper, left an indelible mark on the music industry with a net worth of $26 million at the time of his untimely death in 2022. He was an integral part of the dynamic hip-hop trio Migos, alongside his relatives Quavo and Offset. Their collective talent and relentless work ethic elevated Migos to unprecedented heights in the world of hip-hop. Migos, the trio that brought him widespread recognition, is renowned for its innovative sound and significant contributions to the genre. The group's success is reflected in their impressive earnings and streaming numbers. Between September 2017 and September 2018, Migos earned a staggering $25 million. This considerable income was primarily the result of their intense touring schedule. During this period, the group performed 93 shows, demonstrating their commitment to connecting with fans across the globe. Their extensive tour was a crucial component of their financial success, as live performances play a significant role in generating revenue for artists. In addition to their tour earnings, Migos also garnered remarkable streaming success. The trio accumulated 4 billion streams between September 2017 and September 2018, solidifying their status as one of the most popular streaming artists of the time. This immense digital footprint underscores the widespread appeal of their music and the significant role streaming platforms play in modern music consumption. The following year, from September 2018 to September 2019, Migos saw even greater financial success, earning $36 million. This increase in earnings highlights the group's continued relevance and growing influence in the music industry. Their ability to attract and maintain a massive audience through both live performances and digital streaming was a key factor in their impressive revenue growth. Takeoff, born Kershnik Kariball on June 18, 1994, in Lawrenceville, Georgia, emerged as one of the most influential figures in modern hip-hop. Nestled near Atlanta, a city renowned for its vibrant music scene, Lawrenceville provided a formative backdrop for Takeoff's early years. Raised by his mother, Takeoff grew up alongside his cousins Quavius Kiate Marshall and Kiari Kendrell Cephas, who would later become his bandmates in the groundbreaking trio Migos. Their close-knit family bond and shared love for music set the stage for their eventual rise to fame. From a young age, Takeoff and his cousins were heavily influenced by the sounds of the Southern rap scene. They drew inspiration from iconic artists like Gucci Mane, Outkast, and Lil Wayne, whose distinctive styles and lyrical prowess shaped their musical tastes. This early exposure to influential rap music played a crucial role in shaping Takeoff's own artistic vision and approach. A memorable year 2008, Takeoff, alongside his uncle Quavius, better known as Quavo, and his cousin Kiari, known as Offset, founded the group Migos. Initially operating under the name Polo Club, the trio began honing their craft and building a name for themselves in the underground rap scene. Their debut mixtape, Juke Season, released in 2011, marked the beginning of their journey. The project, while modest in its initial impact, laid the foundation for their future success. Migos continued to build momentum with their 2012 mixtape, No Label, which showcased their evolving sound and lyrical depth. The mixtape, though not a commercial blockbuster, solidified their presence in the rap community and demonstrated their potential. The group's breakthrough came in 2013 with the release of their single, Versace. This track, characterized by its catchy hooks and distinctive beats, captured the attention of fans and critics alike. The song gained further prominence when Canadian rapper Drake remixed it, propelling it into the limelight. Versace achieved notable success, peaking at number 99 on the Billboard Hot 100 and climbing to number 31 on the Hot R&B Hip Hop Songs chart. The single's success was a significant milestone for Migos, marking their transition from a local act to a national sensation. Versace was later featured on Migos' mixtape, YRN, Young Rich Niggas, which further cemented their reputation in the hip-hop world. Building on this momentum, Migos released No Label 2, a sequel to their earlier mixtape. The project garnered substantial attention, with over 100,000 downloads in its first week, signaling the growing demand for their music. The group's success continued with the release of Fright Night in 2014. The single, known for its energetic beats and memorable lyrics, achieved a peak position of number 69 on the Billboard Hot 100, further establishing Migos as a formidable force in the music industry. Next year, the dynamic hip-hop trio Migos took a significant step in their musical career with the release of their debut studio album, Young Rich Nation. This album marked a pivotal moment for the group, showcasing their evolving sound and cementing their place in the rap industry. Featuring notable collaborations with artists like Young Thug and Chris Brown, Young Rich Nation quickly gained attention and acclaim. The album reached an impressive number 3 on the top rap albums chart and made its mark on the Billboard 200, peaking at number 17. Among its standout tracks was the hit single, One Time, which resonated with fans and contributed to the album's success. September 2015 saw the release of a new mixtape from Migos titled Back to the Bando. This project was significant for several reasons, one of which was the introduction of the track, Look at My Dab. This song played a crucial role in popularizing the dabbing dance move, which became a global sensation. The infectious beat and catchy lyrics helped propel Look at My Dab into the spotlight, further establishing Migos as trendsetters in the hip-hop community. Additionally, in 2015, Migos collaborated with Rich the Kid on the album Streets on Lock 4, continuing to expand their influence and showcase their versatility. The year 2016 marked a turning point for Migos with the release of Bad and Bougie, a track featuring Lil Uzi Vert. This single became a massive hit and was the lead single from the group's second album, Culture. Bad and Bougie achieved remarkable success, reaching number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 and earning a quadruple platinum certification from the RIAA. However, it's notable that Takeoff, one of the trio's key members, was not featured or credited on the track. During its recording, Takeoff was occupied with other commitments, which led to his absence from this landmark single. The release of Culture in January 2017 was a significant milestone for Migos. The album debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200, selling approximately 130,000 album equivalent units in its first week. Culture was not only a commercial success but also a cultural phenomenon, solidifying Migos' status as major players in the hip-hop world. The album achieved platinum status by July 2017, further demonstrating its widespread appeal and impact. In late 2017, Migos continued their momentum with the release of Motorsport, the lead single from their third studio album, Culture 2. Featuring high-profile rappers Nicki Minaj and Cardi B, Motorsport became a hit, peaking at number 6 on the Billboard Hot 100. The success of this single was complemented by the release of the second single from Culture 2, Stir Fry, which also performed well, reaching number 8 on the charts. The album, Culture 2, released in January 2018, continued the group's streak of success, debuting at number 1 on the Billboard 200 and selling nearly 200,000 album equivalent units in its first week. The highly anticipated album, Culture 3, was initially scheduled for release in 2020 but faced delays due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The album was eventually released on June 11, 2021, continuing Migos' legacy of innovative and influential music. Despite their professional achievements, Migos faced personal and public challenges. In October 2022, rumors began circulating about a potential split within the group, fueled by reports that Quavo's ex-girlfriend Saweetie had allegedly cheated on him with Offset. These rumors created a cloud of uncertainty around the group's future. However, before Takeoff's tragic death, Quavo and Takeoff released the album, Only Built for Infinity Links, just 25 days before his passing. This release served as a poignant reminder of the group's enduring talent and creative spirit. Next, we invite you to explore the houses that have had his presence right now. Migos Atlanta Mansion. The hip-hop trio Migos, celebrated for their chart-topping hits and infectious tunes, once called a grand mansion in Atlanta, Georgia, their home. This opulent estate, situated on a tranquil and exclusive street in Sandy Springs, spans 1.8 acres and is valued at over $2 million. The property epitomizes luxury and privacy, offering picturesque views and a serene atmosphere, ideal for high-profile celebrities seeking both comfort and discretion. The mansion's design reflects a meticulous blend of elegance and modernity. The residence is spread across 3 finished floors, each seamlessly connected by a high-end elevator and dual staircases at both the front and rear of the home. The property boasts custom trim work, floor-to-ceiling windows, and ceilings that soar above 10 feet, creating a sense of grandeur and openness. Upon entering the mansion, visitors are greeted by a two-story foyer that sets the tone for the rest of the home. High ceilings and an abundance of natural light flood the space, creating an inviting and airy atmosphere. The gourmet kitchen, a centerpiece of the home, features top-of-the-line Thermidor appliances, a spacious island, a dining area, and a dedicated wine and coffee bar. This culinary haven is perfect for both intimate family meals and lavish gatherings. The great room, with its cozy fireplace, serves as a central gathering spot for relaxation and entertainment. The room's design is both functional and stylish, making it a perfect venue for hosting guests. Adjacent to the great room is a custom-built office, designed by Chuck Tice, which stands out as a sophisticated workspace within the home. One of the mansion's highlights is the arched screened porch and large deck, which offer sweeping views of the lush, newly landscaped backyard. This outdoor space is ideal for leisure and entertaining, with ample room for a potential pool or other luxury amenities. The landscape, meticulously maintained with new turf and landscaping, enhances the property's tranquil and luxurious ambiance. The main floor of the mansion also includes a formal dining room, perfect for hosting elegant dinners, and a practical pantry for added convenience. The master suite is a sanctuary of comfort, featuring vaulted ceilings and a fireplace. The adjoining spa-like bathroom is equipped with heated floors, a champagne tub, a large shower, and an expansive walk-in closet, providing a luxurious retreat for relaxation. Upstairs, the home offers a guest suite and two additional bedrooms, which share a Jack and Jill bathroom, catering to both family and guests. A conveniently located laundry room adds to the home's functionality and ease of living. The pinnacle of the mansion is the spectacular rooftop deck, designed with entertainment in mind. This expansive space features 10 to 12 foot ceilings and includes a kitchen, a media room, and two bedrooms. One of these bedrooms is particularly well suited for exercise, reflecting the home's emphasis on wellness and recreation. The rooftop also includes a full bathroom, adding to its practicality as an entertainment space. With its sophisticated design, serene surroundings, and an array of impeccable amenities, this residence served as a haven for the hip-hop trio during their time together. While Migos has since pursued individual paths, their shared experience in this magnificent home will forever be a part of their journey to success. Mansion in Roswell, Georgia. Following his departure from the hip-hop trio Migos, Takeoff's personal living arrangements were often shrouded in mystery. Despite the lack of public information about his own residence, Takeoff made headlines in 2017 for a deeply personal and generous gesture, along with his uncle Quavo, purchased a stunning home for his mother, Edna Marshall. This significant investment, valued at $560,000, underscores Takeoff's commitment to his family and highlights his thoughtful nature. The residence in question is a five-bedroom, five-bathroom gem that exemplifies both elegance and functionality. Its exterior combines striking brickwork with carefully chosen architectural details, creating a facade that is both inviting and impressive. The home's design captures attention from the moment you approach, setting the stage for the luxurious features found within. Upon entering the home, visitors are greeted by a gracefully curved two-story lobby staircase. This architectural feature adds a touch of grandeur and sophistication, serving as a dramatic entry point into the living space. The formal dining room, framed by notched columns, exudes charm and refinement, making it an ideal setting for elegant dinners and special gatherings. The living room is designed to maximize comfort and visual appeal. Floor-to-ceiling windows flood the space with natural light, offering stunning views of the surrounding landscape. A dual-sided fireplace not only serves as a central focal point but also provides warmth and coziness, enhancing the room's inviting atmosphere. Custom bookshelves add a personalized touch and offer practical storage solutions for books and decorative items. The kitchen, a key feature of this residence, is tailored for those who enjoy cooking and entertaining. Equipped with a top-of-the-line chef's stove, granite countertops, and a convenient breakfast bar, it is both functional and stylish. Additional features, such as a cloakroom and breakfast room, enhance the overall flow and usability of the space. Stepping out onto the spacious deck reveals a picturesque panorama of a private forest, creating a serene setting perfect for outdoor relaxation and entertaining. The master suite of the home is a luxurious retreat. A prominent fireplace provides warmth and ambiance, while the accompanying travertine marble bathroom offers a spa-like experience. This bathroom, with its elegant design and high-end finishes, is designed for ultimate relaxation and pampering, making it a standout feature of the residence. The home also includes a beautifully designed custom terrace level. This area features an in-law's bedroom, providing both comfort and privacy for guests. A full suite, complete with a bedroom and bathroom, adds to the home's functionality. Additionally, a screened porch offers a tranquil space to enjoy the outdoors while remaining sheltered from the elements, further enhancing the property's versatility. Although Takeoff's own residential journey might remain less visible to the public, his act of purchasing this exquisite home for his mother reflects his deep appreciation and commitment to family. This gesture highlights that success is not solely defined by personal accomplishments but also by the care and generosity extended to loved ones who have supported us along the way. Personal life. As an artist who achieved significant fame and success, it's no surprise that rumors and speculation about his romantic relationships frequently surfaced. Despite his public persona, Takeoff managed to maintain a high degree of privacy regarding his personal affairs. Takeoff's rise to fame began in earnest in 2013 with the release of the hit single Versace. During this period, his career was rapidly gaining momentum, and while his professional life was in the spotlight, his romantic life remained relatively private. It wasn't until later that year that whispers of a potential romance began to surface, particularly when Takeoff collaborated with pop sensation Katy Perry. Their joint project, Bon Appetit, led to increased speculation about their personal connection. The rumors gained traction when Takeoff and Perry were seen together at a Saturday Night Live afterparty. According to reports from Hollywood Life, the pair clearly hit it off during their time working on the track. Despite the chemistry observed by many, there was no official confirmation of a romantic relationship between the two. The speculation dwindled over time, especially as Katy Perry's personal life took a new direction with her relationship with Orlando Bloom and the birth of their child. This shift in Perry's life marked the end of the romance rumors between her and Takeoff. As of 2018, another round of rumors began to swirl around Takeoff, this time involving the artist Dreamdoll. Speculation suggested that Takeoff might have been romantically linked to Dreamdoll, though neither party publicly confirmed or denied the rumors. The lack of official statements left fans and media alike to wonder about the nature of their relationship, fueling ongoing curiosity about Takeoff's personal life. Legal issues. Beneath the glittering veneer of fame, Takeoff and his bandmates faced several legal issues that cast a shadow over their career. The first significant legal issue occurred in April 2015 when Migos was slated to headline Georgia Southern University's spring concert. The performance, eagerly anticipated by fans, quickly became a source of controversy. The trio arrived on stage nearly an hour and a half late, an unfortunate delay that set the tone for what would become a problematic event. Once on stage, Migos performed for less than 30 minutes, falling short of the contracted 45-minute performance requirement. This breach of contract not only disappointed fans but also drew scrutiny from the event organizers. The situation escalated when law enforcement detected the odor of marijuana emanating from the group's vehicle. This led to an investigation by local authorities, who discovered that the group and their entourage were in possession of narcotics. The legal complications did not end there. The charges extended to include possession of a weapon in a school safety zone, as well as possession of a weapon by a convicted felon. The legal fallout from the Georgia Southern incident was swift. 2 days after their arrest, Takeoff, Quavo, and six members of their entourage were released on bail. However, Offset and six other individuals remained in custody, unable to secure bail at that time. This episode highlighted the legal risks associated with the lifestyle of high-profile musicians and the consequences of legal infractions. A few years later, in July 2017, Takeoff found himself in trouble again, this time under more routine circumstances. Before boarding a flight from Atlanta to Des Moines, Iowa, Takeoff encountered a disagreement with airline staff. The issue arose when he allegedly refused to move his bag from the floor to the overhead bin, a common request from flight attendants for the safety and comfort of passengers. His reluctance to comply led to a dispute that resulted in him being asked to leave the plane. While this incident may seem less severe compared to the earlier legal trouble, it nonetheless underscores the challenges and scrutiny that come with being in the public eye. Death and inheritance. On November 1, 2022, the music world and fans around the globe were struck by a tragic loss. Takeoff, a prominent figure in the hip-hop industry and member of the influential group Migos, died in Houston early this morning. The artist was only 28 years old at the time of his death. His passing was a shock to many, and it left a void in the music community that would be hard to fill. In the aftermath of this tragedy, justice has been a key focus. By May 2023, Patrick Xavier Clark was indicted by a grand jury in connection with Takeoff's death. If convicted of the charges against him, Clark could face a prison sentence ranging from 5 years to life. The legal process continues as the justice system works to ensure accountability for this heartbreaking incident. Takeoff's funeral took place in Atlanta, reflecting the profound impact he had on his community and fans. The memorial service, held at State Farm Arena, was a grand affair. The venue, capable of accommodating over 20,000 people, was filled with mourners who came to pay their respects. The ceremony was overseen by Takeoff's childhood pastor, Rev. Jesse Kearney, who offered a heartfelt tribute to the young star. In the wake of Takeoff's death, legal and financial matters concerning his estate have come to the forefront. Under Georgia law, in the absence of a will, Takeoff's closest relatives are set to inherit his estate and personal assets. This includes his extensive music catalog and the residual income from his record sales, which signifies a substantial financial legacy. However, the distribution and management of Takeoff's estate have become a point of contention between his surviving family members. His mother, Titania Davenport Treat, and his father, Kenneth M. Ball, are reportedly in disagreement over how the estate should be handled. The lack of a will has complicated matters, as both parties vie for control over Takeoff's assets. It is noteworthy that Takeoff often spoke about his upbringing in his music and interviews, indicating that he was raised primarily by his mother. This detail adds another layer of complexity to the ongoing dispute, highlighting the personal and emotional stakes involved in the estate proceedings. As the legal and familial challenges continue to unfold, Takeoff's legacy remains a significant aspect of his memory. His contributions to music and his influence on the hip-hop genre are celebrated and remembered by fans and peers alike. If you found this exploration of Takeoff's life and legacy insightful, please consider supporting my channel by liking, sharing, and subscribing. Your engagement helps me continue bringing you detailed content on the lives of your favorite celebrities. If you have any thoughts or questions about Takeoff's story or future topics you'd like me to cover, drop them in the comments below. Thank you for your support and for joining me in remembering and honoring Takeoff's remarkable journey. Thanks for watching and see you in the next videos. Goodbye.